Okay, so I recently took some pain pills, and yes, I feel sleepy, but I don't feel sleepy enough to go to bed. So I was watching John Oliver's stand-up comedy show, and Ali Wong was on, and she is funny. And she has inspired me to be completely honest. So, first of all, when you pray to God, you're supposed to believe that it happened and act accordingly. So, I believe that I've already won the Publishers Clearing House $7,000 a week lottery. And I'm gonna go ahead and start building up my wish list of shit I want so that I can order the stuff easily when I maybe I should go for HP. When I actually get my first check. Because the first check is going to be like $1 million, and then after that, it's $7,000 a week. Whatever, I'm not gonna. I don't feel like doing this right now. But anyway, Ali Wong was saying what she wanted in a man, so I've decided I'm gonna be completely honest about what I want in a man. Because for what feels like my whole life, or at least since my father passed away when I was 15, I have been in charge. When we moved from Maryland down south, and we were having our house built, excuse me, my mother always had me speak to the what do you call it, contractor. Like after it was finished, they had installed carpet, but in the living room it was a different texture. It was all supposed to be like deep pile soft, but the kind in the living room was, short pile and not the same. And so I was talking to him, the contractor, like we shouldn't have to pay this much for this. Because it's a different quality of carpet that's in the rest of the room. I mean, I was 15. Why the hell am I talking to the contractor? But also she, well, it took months and months after they said they were gonna be finished. And so she had them paying our rent for the months while we were waiting for the house to be built, which I think she took care of herself. But that's what I mean by I feel like I've been in charge. Like when I was a kid and we lived in Germany, she would always have me speak to the German shopkeeper. What cost of that? I mean, she knew what the phrase was, so I don't know why she couldn't say it herself, but she had me do it. And then, when my father was alive, my father did it. And so I've always been in charge. And when I was in school, when there was a group project, I always became the default leader. Not because I wanted to lead, but because I knew that nobody else would take charge. And, I'm like, I'm not going to get a bad grade just because of these other fools. So I ended up being in charge. And I want a man who will take charge. Now, the problem with a man who will take charge is that I have to be able to trust him to make good decisions. And the men that I have met in my life, they start out strong, but then they turn into my bitch. And that is no longer attractive. Once I start telling you, go do this, go do that, like wash the dishes, cook me something to eat, treating him basically like my slave, that is not attractive to me. And so she was talking about, I understand why 50 Shades of Grey has been such a great bestseller, because the women in the book, or the woman, I don't know, I haven't read it, she's like being dominated. And that's what I want, honestly. I want a man to dominate me sexually. I mean, I have no problem saying I want sex now, but, you know, I want him to take charge. You know, if you ask me on a date, make plans for the date. Don't say you want to go out, and I say sure, and then you say, oh, where do you want to go? What do you want to do? I don't know. That's your job. You asked me out, make a plan. So that's what kind of man I want, but I just can't seem to find that kind of man. And I don't know what it is. I'm not into BDSM. I mean, I don't mind a little spanking. I don't mind anal sex, you know, but just in general, be a man. I don't like this thing where they're trying to get all these men to be in touch with their feminine sides, and it's basically turning them into punk-ass bitches, little pussies. I don't want to have to stroke your ego all goddamn time. I mean, I'll stroke your ego if I feel like you deserve it, but not, you know, oh, you put the toilet lid down. Good boy. That's what I did to my child when he was, you know, in the single digits, because that's what you have to do to your child. But a grown-ass man, I shouldn't have to remind you to put the seat down. You know, I shouldn't have to tell you to take out the trash. You should notice that the trash is full, take the trash out, and put a new bag in. That's what a man is supposed to do. Okay? Okay, what else? I don't know. I'm just kind of bored. And I swear to God, I have been out of the house every motherfucking day this week. Well, I did not go out on the 3rd, which was Tuesday. I didn't go out on Monday because that was Labor Day. And I didn't go out. Well, I went out on the 3rd, but I didn't go to, like, Walmart or anything, because I knew that all the disabled and retired people would be out there, and it would be crowded. So, but I did have some errands to run, like I went and paid my electricity bill and stuff. So that was on the 3rd. So on the 4th, I went to the doctor and got a prescription for pain meds, and then I went to Walmart to put the prescription in, and they said it wouldn't go through. They tried it on my Medicaid, and then, since Medicaid wouldn't cover it, they tried my Humana, and then they said, well, it's not ready today, but it might be ready tomorrow. So I had to go back home. On the 5th, which was Thursday, I called Humana in the morning and asked them why it wouldn't go through, and she told me, well, I can see that they tried your Medicaid, and I don't know why it's not going through on your, what is it called? Humana, but right now, I'm putting it through, and so it should be ready. So that's fine. And I called Walmart, and they said that my prescription was ready. So I went and picked it up. Is it higher or lower than a 10? I'm going to gamble. See, if I'd have said lower, you know, because you think, if it's a 10, there are more lower cards than 10s in the deck. There are only 4 10s. But I tell you what, every time I go with the odds or what seems logical, it always turns. Like, if I had pushed higher, then it would. Whatever. I don't know what I just did. So, whatever happens, it always does the opposite. It never lets me get past, like, $250 or whatever. So, anyway. So then Friday, what did I go out for? I don't know. Friday was, you know, I know this is technically Sunday, but it feels like Saturday. So Friday, I took the boy to Walmart and we got some food and shit. And, I mean, some refrigerated food for him. So then Saturday, which is today, he wanted some fast food. And I'm like, well, I'm not driving. And I only have $7 cash. But then I remembered that I had applied for that Walmart credit card, and as long as you had your receipt, you're supposed to be able to use the credit card. The cashier would just enter the information. And then it turned out that I had to use the card by the 5th, and Friday was the 6th, or Saturday was the 7th, so it was too late. And I'm like, after I picked out all that shit, you know, like I got a Duck Dynasty shirt with Uncle Si saying, "Booyah!" And I got a new bra. Oh, I bought a new bra on Friday. And since I've lost so much weight and, you know, the bras that I have, the bands are too big. So I went down a couple of band sizes and I thought, you know, my boobs are smaller. Now, Martin Dobson, or Dodson, I can't remember his name right now, but I'm just telling you, Martin Dodson told me that my boobs would never change size. They might get a little saggy, but they won't change size. And I'd always been wearing C-cup bras, and so I thought, okay, maybe I'm a B-cup now. So whatever, I just got a 2X B-cup bra, I guess. You know, it was one of those without underwire. Or it was like not a sports bra, but something like that. It had no underwire and yada yada. So I put it on, and it basically was a minimizer. Now, here's my problem with bras. They think that just because you're fat, you're going to have huge boobs. So the bras were like 44D or 44 double D. And I'm like, can I get a 44C or whatever? But no, I couldn't. So whatever. I'm going to have to get some new bras, and I guess I can't get these bras that are 44B. Anymore, like the one that I bought myself. Like, I usually get my bras from my mother, but you know, like I said, I've lost weight, so her bras are too big for me, and I had to sew that one bra that came apart on its own, you know, clothes, so that it wouldn't come apart. But you know, the cups are way too big, and that is a whatever C. So I thought, well, since I'm no longer filling the cups, then I must have lost some weight in my boobies. And so that's why I tried the B. But no. I finally found the, yeah, see? I gambled. I finally found a 44. Finally found a 44C, and that's the one that looked like it was a minimizer on my boobs. Or I'm sorry, a 44B. So whatever. Next time I go to Walmart, I'll have to get a 44C.